AI video tools are moving so fast right now. And if you're like me, you probably feel that chaos, juggling subscriptions, switching between interfaces, and trying to figure out how to prompt each one just right. It's overwhelming and expensive. But here's the thing. What if the real game changer wasn't which one you use, but how you prompted it? I found a prompting framework that actually works across every AI video model. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use that framework inside OpenArt's new all-in-one video platform, where you can create not only text-to-video and image-to-video, even combine elements into animated scenes, and add sound effects or lip sync without bouncing between tools. By the end of this video, you'll know how to prompt any AI video model and get consistent cinematic results every time. Let's jump right in. First on the dashboard, let's get into the video section. If you don't have an account yet, grab the link in the description below. Here we can create videos with text to video, where you start with a simple description, image to video, where you animate a still image, element to video, where we can combine multiple characters or objects into a single moving scene. Plus, we can also add sound effects and even lip sync to the videos, all directly within the platform. In both text to video and image to video, you'll find many of the top video models available for you to use. For elements to video, it currently supports only the Kling 1.6, but I believe more models will be added soon as this feature grows. Let's first take a look at text to video. In the text to video section, you can select from different models. You'll see that we have Kling 1.6, the newly added Pixverse, Vidu, Hailuo 1.2.1, VO2, and Kling 2.0. If you're unfamiliar with these models, OpenArt has added short descriptions underneath each one. They give you a quick idea of what each model specializes in, so you can choose the best to fit your project. For example, my favorite model, Kling 2.0, is known for high prompt adherence and outstanding aesthetic. Another popular one, VO2, is good at simulating real-world physics and offering a variety of visual styles. And of course, these strengths may evolve over time as the model improves, but it's a good starting point to pick one. I'll be testing a few different models for you so you can compare and see the differences. But first, let's take a look at how text-to-video works on OpenArt. Here is where we enter our text prompt. And if you're unsure how to write a prompt, you can also upload an image. And the AI will analyze the image and generate a descriptive text for you as a starting point. We can send the text to the prompt section and to further edit. On top of that, we can also add auto sound, which adds environmental sound effect automatically, or auto speech, which lets you add voiceover and lip sync characters to custom dialogue. Down here, we can adjust various settings, and different models might have slightly different options like available durations, resolution, and quality, different aspect ratios, and other control settings such as the creativity level, which control how creative or adherent you want the AI to be. Some models also have negative prompts, so you can tell AI what you do not want to appear in the generated video. But the most important part in text to video, no matter which model you use, is the text prompt. Most beginners write something simple like a man walking in the forest. With this kind of simple prompt, you can turn on auto enhance for the AI to add more details to your prompt. But to prompt in any AI video model effectively with more control, there's a 5-part prompt structure that works across all models: subject, action, environment, lighting and atmosphere, and camera movement. Subject description is who or what is in your scene with specific details. Action is what is happening or what movement you want. Environments are the settings or background details. Lighting and atmospheres are mood, time of day, weather, or emotion. And camera movement is how the shot should be framed or move. And for your convenience, here's some common camera movement terminology that you can use in your prompt. So if we expand the prompt using the 5-part framework, then it would be a rugged man wearing a brown jacket, dark pants, and brown boots, carefully walks through a dense mist-shrouded forest of towering pines. Golden sunlight filters through the canopy, creating dramatic shadows. The camera pushes back, tracking his forward movement. And you can see that this is written by AI, not my language. Let me try a few different video models using the same prompt. First up, here's the result with a basic prompt on Kling 2.0. It's not bad because it's Kling 2.0 and it generally delivers strong realism emotion. I would say it's usable, but the scene feels a bit flat and lacks the details and cinematic quality we usually want to have in our movies. Fair comparison, let's take a look at how other models perform using the same prompt with specific details. Vidu handles the character and scene decently, but completely ignore my camera direction. And for this fast model, I found it tends to make more mistakes sometimes. Note that this is not their most updated version. Pixverse sticks closely to the prompt. Like many other models, it defaults to a slow motion effect, which personally I preferred it to output in the real time and let us adjust the speed ourselves. Hailuo didn't follow the camera movement either. The motion was passable, but the character loses details in full body shot and it's a bit blurry. 1.2.1 missed the camera instructions as well, but we should note that the model tends to follow camera directions better if you place them first in the prompt for this model. The motion feels choppy, likely because it runs at 16 frames per second compared to the 24 frames per second we're used to in films. VO2 has solid body movement and great prompt adherence. The visual is very detailed overall. And Kling 1.6 is the most realistic by far. The camera angle came out lower than I expected, but otherwise it sticks to the prompt decently. And Kling 2.0 is really the best model. It's the most prompt adherent with super realistic movement and unmatched visual fidelity. In my opinion, it's just a lot better than the other ones at this point. Here's a side-by-side look at all of them for comparison. Although this prompting structure works across all models, you might need to tweak it slightly depending on the one you're using. For example, the order of information you prompt matters. Most models give higher priority to what's mentioned first. So if style or camera movement is crucial and you can't quite get it right, try leading with that. For more tips on fine-tuning prompts across models, check out my free guide in the description. Text to video is great for stock footage or B-roll when you don't really need full control over the look. But if you're aiming for a specific look or style, image to video is generally the most used option. Let's try image to video to create more consistent results. Other than the previous models we see on text to video, we can also find Hailuo Live, which is good for 2D illustration. Here we can upload a starting frame to serve as the first frame of the video for it to animate. Upload an image from the computer or from generation history. We'll select a character we have on OpenArt as the starting frame. Let's start with this image. Like in text to video, we can add sound effects, lip sync, and tweak different settings down here, depending on the model you choose. Now, when it comes to prompting, there's a small but important difference. In text to video, we need to include all 5 parts of our framework. But for image to video, the subject, environment, and sometimes the lighting are already defined by your image. So usually you only need to focus on action and camera movement. And here's my prompt. The woman's hair and clothes gently wave in the mountain breeze as she takes a deep breath. The clouds drift slowly across the sky. The camera gradually pulls back to reveal more of the landscape. Now let's generate this across different models and see how they handle the same prompts. Vidu follows the camera direction this time, but the woman appears stiff. The camera moves faster than intended. And Pixverse sticks to the prompt pretty well, and it gives a natural and visually beautiful result. Hailuo once again ignores the camera instruction. It pushed in instead of pull back. But I actually like the shift in focus here and find the shot quite visually pleasing. 1.2.1 has noticeable jitter again. It feels like a sped up time lapse. And the camera circles the subject instead of pulling back. Like I mentioned, placing camera movement first might help with this model. VO2 doesn't pull back as prompted, but the hair movement, head tilt, and the facial details make it feel lifelike and visually strong. Kling 1.6 mostly follows the prompt and looks realistic, though the deep breath motion is not very obvious. And Kling 2.0 remains strong in prompt adherence and delivers the most cinematic shot of all. For me, Kling 2.0 and Pixverse are the clear winners in this round. Some models let you control the last frame of an animation, which is great for creating smooth transition between a start and end frame. Let's generate a custom last frame from this image. This time, instead of using the regular editing interface, I'm trying out OpenArt's new chat editing feature. In here, we just have to upload an image and then chat with the AI to make changes like changing colors, swapping backgrounds, and tweaking poses. We can now choose between Gemini or GPT models for chat editing. The basic, medium, and high are different image quality for you to choose from. I prefer the GPT one for now. It has stronger prompt adherence and create more consistent results. There are also preset templates you can click to auto-populate the prompt to the chat. You don't even have to think of what to say in here. In here, we can upload the starting image to edit. Upload your starting image here and you can start asking the chat to edit. We can upload multiple reference images. I want to add this dog to the scene, so I uploaded the reference image of the dog from here. And then we just have to chat in natural language. Add this dog to the scene. You'll notice the dog gets added, but the overall style and character change because the original image was made with a Flux model and GPT is recreating it, and right now the models can fully match styles from different models, but I think they try to stay close. To keep visual consistency, it's best to generate both start and end frames using the same model. I eventually asked the chat to remove the dog. After all, a corgi isn't exactly built for forest. It did remove the dog, but changed my aspect ratio. So I asked it to switch back to landscape. The result was a bit distorted, so I had it recreate the original image again. Once that was fixed, I asked to add an explosion behind him. And the explosion came out a little bit too big, so I told it to scale it down and make the character look back in fear. And this is what we get. Some of the image could be low resolution, we can upscale, add the frame to image to video, or download from here. The character GPT model created are more similar to each other, and I decided to use these two images as the start and end frame of the video. Back to image to video, I uploaded both frames and hit create. If you add auto audio, sometimes there would be background music or singing like this. It gives you good ideas of what environmental sound can fit the scene quickly. And this whole transition was very natural. I am surprised that the sound effect picked up the weird movement in his backpack and added the monster growling. Maybe he stole a dinosaur in his backpack and now the mountain god wants revenge? The elements feature in OpenArt lets you upload up to 4 images. These can be characters, objects, garments, environments, or even animal faces. And the AI will help combine them together into a single video. Right now, you can only use Kling 1.6 model for this feature, but as more models start playing the same game, I'm sure they will see more options and add it soon. Let's try it out. I'll upload 4 images. A woman, a teddy bear, a room, and a dress. When we are writing the text prompt for elements, you want to describe the actions and interactions between these elements. For example, the woman wearing a dress is hugging her teddy bear in the room. Keep it simple and direct to avoid confusing the AI. Let's generate and see what we get. I'm super impressed that the bedroom looks just like my reference photo, and the teddy bear and the character's face are almost spot on. The dress isn't an exact match, but I suspect that's because the image I uploaded had decorated flowers around it, so it's hard to tell which one is the object. Ideally, outfits should be uploaded as clean, flat images, like e-commerce photos, not the stylized and artistic ones that I did. To get outfits to show up correctly, try uploading just a headshot of your character without including any clothing. I mean, not like nude. But just crop. If the original image includes clothes, the AI might blend them with the outfit you prompt later, which can lead to a mixed result like this. I'm super impressed with this one. I uploaded a garden background, but in my prompt, I said the woman was in a room. I also said she was wearing a purple dress, but the dress that I uploaded was more of a pink color. So this is how the AI interpreted my mixed signals. The dress that is hanging there does look exactly like the dress I uploaded. I like how it shows the room and also didn't forget to include the garden at the same time. I think it's pretty amazing that the AI tried its best to fit everything together logically. Though it did flip the laptop lid the wrong way, but I think it's an honest mistake. We can also place multiple characters in the same scene. Not sure why the woman's facing away, the man's walking backward, and they're both ignoring the creepy teddy bear just sitting there in the garden. This one is pure brutality. But maybe the AI thought this was more logical than having the teddy bear walk alongside them. And this one is either going for comedy or trying to make a horror film. I'm not so sure. Still, you have to appreciate how it tried to make sense of all the elements and try to fit everything into one scene. Now let's check out the audio feature. In the previous examples, you got auto sound and the lip sync automatically when generating videos. But with this tab, you can upload an already generated video and add sound effects or lip sync on top of it. Let's upload this clip and test the sound effects first. Here, you can type in an instruction for the kind of sound effect you want. For example, I'll write an animal roar in the background as the man walks across the forest. You can also choose to keep the original sound if your video already has audio and the sound effect will be added on top of the original. But I don't really want that, so I'll leave it unchecked. Right now, you can't add auto speech and auto sound at the same time. So we'll test auto speech separately. Let's create and see what we get. The animal roar ended up sounding a bit like growling, but honestly, I didn't really know the difference until now, so I'll let it pass. I do love how the sounds of footsteps line up with the man's walking, and I like the forest ambient sound blended in. Let's just hope that he makes it out alive. Now let's try auto speech to add a voiceover. Let's use this one. Turn off auto sound, and here we type what we want our character to say. Make sure to check lip sync so the animation matches the lip movements, and then select a voice from the select sound. We can preview the sound.
Your story deserves to be felt. Let OpenArt turn your feelings into visual poetry.
We can also adjust the speed here, but I'll just leave it at the default for now. Let's create.
They told me to grow up, so I got a bigger bear.
This is another example.
Holy smoke, I've got to get out of here.
We cannot really ignore the obvious jittering of the lip area, but we see the potential of how it can improve over time. Having multiple models in one place makes it easy to experiment and find the best fit for your scene. To help you get started, I put together a free universal AI video prompting guide, links below. I really enjoy testing OpenArt's new video features, and if you want to try it out yourself, I've added a link below and a special discount code for you. You can also earn extra credits through their Creative Partner Program. I'll include the link in the description as well. Let me know in the comments which model works best for you. Subscribe for more content like this, and I will see you in the next one.